Hey YouTubers, welcome back to the channel again. How to choose binoculars for you and your needs. There's so many different sizes. Gosh, they're small all the way up to something that's just unbelievably large. And the prices vary. But what do you really need to do what you want to do with your binoculars? And the other question, what does all those numbers mean? 4x32, 8x40, 10x50, they just go on and on. But I'm going to explain to you, and we're going to use the numbers 8x40 because that's what I've got. The first number, the 8, has to do with magnification. In other words, if you'll look at these examples, the top left-hand corner is what you would see with the naked eye. But if you use an 8x magnification, which is the one right below it, this is what you'd see. This could be an advantage or sometimes a disadvantage. And let me show you what I mean. Now here's a potted plant in my backyard and I'm at about 20 feet. The picture's fairly stable, but as you get a little closer, you'll notice that I have a little more movement because of my breathing and you have less field of view. In other words, you can't see the gate anymore. But now when you zoom in it 12 times, now you can see things like cobwebs. Now, let's say that you're watching a field, like this one next to my house. These are the inexpensive 4x20s. You could see someone crossing the field, you know, really good with these. But if you use an 8x, you can see a little more detail. But look how much field of view you have lost. Now you have to start panning to watch the field, which is fine if you want to do so. But if you're just trying to identify a person coming across the field is one thing, but if you want to see exactly who the person is, now you go to a 12x50. Now you've really got to pan the field because the field of view has shortened so much or narrowed so much that you can't see. And they're very shaky. And most people, when they get up into 12x or even the 20x, they'll use a tripod, which even adds more weight. Now for me, it was the midsize, kind of like the bird watcher uses. Something that's got an 8 to 10 power, but are not too heavy and easy to handle. Now let's talk about the second number, 40. Now what does that mean? Well, the second number is the width of the front objective, the front of the thing. 40 millimeters across, 8x40 means 40, 8x50 would be 50. Now something else you should notice about this objective, you see the multi-coding colors of purple haze? A good set of optics will have 7 optic coatings inside and out. This helps a lot with light transition. So you've got an 8x20 and you've got an 8x40. They're both the same power, but what's the difference? Well, here's an 8x20 in low light situations. But let's go now to the 8x40. You see the larger objective allows more light in that you can see in those dark shadows. Now here's my Pentax. And I've had these for at least 10 years. And let me show you a little bit about how to use them. Now you notice I have 2 tabs here, but these are quick release tabs I have for the harness that I wear with these when I'm using them. They're a mid-size. They don't weigh a lot. I think about 23 ounces. And they're made by Pentax. And I purchased Pentax because I knew that Pentax had been in the camera business for years and they had good optics. Now the first adjustment you want to do on a pair of binoculars is the width. See how they rock in and out the distance between the 2 viewfinders? Well, that's, you know, children would be smaller than adults. Now here's the second, is your focus. Now you rotate that and the focus will move in and out. Now to focus them, the first thing you want to do is look through here and focus on the left eye first. Get the left eye focused, then cover up the side of the binocular and turn the focus on the eyepiece for the right eye. Now you have both eyes adjusted and they're set for you. It would be different for other people. Then when you move the focus portion, everything stays in focus. Now here's the shades. These are nice because they're hard plastic. They're rubber coated and they pop out. If you did not wear glasses, you would pull them out. But I do wear glasses and that's another main reason I bought these. Because these have a 20 millimeter eye relief, which when my glasses are up against the front, my eye is back at a distance, so I'm able to see through them very well. Now when you look through them, there's a mirror here. That mirror reflects to this mirror, another mirror, and then it goes out, because you can tell that the eyepiece and the objective end are not in a straight line. Now they do make binoculars that are in a straight line, but those have a roof prism. Now the roof prism, the difference is the mirror is at the top, and it reflects down to another mirror so that it keeps it straight. But those do not gather light as well as this type. Now, if you beat and bang your binoculars around, you could knock these mirrors out of line. And there's nothing worse than having a pair of binoculars out of line. And that's why it's important that this portion here, the hinged area between the two pieces of the binocular, is very stable, very good. Because if you get them out of line, you're going to see double vision, and that's not going to be good. They'll get kind of canted or cocked from each other. You want everything to be in line. And these have a very good center hinge. They're rubber coated. That way they're kind of protected if they're beat and banged around. And as you can see, it is a 40 millimeter objective. And that's the distance across the front of the objective lens. Now, tested by pure stupidity is what I did when I first got these. In 2002, I had went on a hunting trip with a friend in the Ozark National Forest. And as we arrived, as you can see, it was very stormy and it rained constantly for 2 days. Everything was soaking wet. I kept my binoculars under my raincoat or inside my hunting jacket. And as you can see, the camp is just soaked. Water was running through the mountains right next to the tents. I was successful. Everything went really good until I got home. And on my way home, I'd used an old cooler that had the latch broken off of it. And I'd used straps and used it as a dry box. Put everything I could find in that box and carried it on my way home. The problem was is I took everything out but these binoculars. These binoculars sat in that cooler without the lid latched for 6 weeks in 6 inches of water and beat and banged around in the back of my pickup truck. Took me an hour and a half to get them clean, guys. But no water went inside, and they were perfectly good binoculars after I cleaned them. Thanks for watching.